Hi you guys, it's Miss Alexa. Welcome to Intermediate Tap. I miss you guys, and I hope you guys are dancing and staying healthy and safe at home. I am in Chicago, back home, and this is this dance studio where I grew up at, which is kind of cool to be back here and to be teaching from here. So we're gonna warm up, do some things in the center. If you have a tap board, I would obviously recommend you use that and not scratching up your parents' hardwood floors. but obviously I hope you have your tap shoes on. So let's warm up our feet. I don't know why the music is doing.
Yeah.
my first colored pair of tap shoes. And the shoe just doesn't like to stay tied. But these are not as broken as the ones I have back home in LA. Okay, let's do our other ankle exercises with the tip of our tap shoe and then the ball of our foot. You guys, I'm sweating. Making me sweat over here. It's a good thing. Hopefully you can hear me and the music is not that loud. It's too loud for you. Just so we can keep a consistent tempo. So we have 8 digs on the right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 heels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 toes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 heels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we do the same thing on the left. Then we do 4s. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 heels. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 toes. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 4 heels. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same thing on the left. Then we do 2s. 1, 2, heel, heel, toe, toe, heel, heel. Heel, heel, toe, toe, heel, heel. We'll do that a couple times. And then we do singles. Big heel, toe, heel. Big heel, toe, heel. We'll do it 100 times until I tell you that we'll run the next. So we do that. And then, this is kind of where it gets a little bit tricky. In between every, so your right foot is always going to stay the same and your left foot is always going to stay the same. Now we're adding in heels and toes on the opposite foot. So we start with our digs. Dig, and then we add an opposite heel. Dig, opposite heel. This is 3. We do 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Same thing. Heels on the right, heels on the left. Heel, 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 heel. 5, 6, 7, 8. Same thing. Your right foot never changes. Toes are next. Toes add up to heel. Toe, opposite heel. Toe, opposite heel. 5, 6, 7, 8, and then back to heels. Heel, 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 heel. 5, 6, 7. Do a double heel on your right foot, so then your left foot is free. So we're just switch, switch, switch. Six, adding the same thing that we just did, but adding toes instead of heels. Woo! Okay, ready?
We're gonna have a storm over here.
What?
Okay, ready on the right foot. Here we go.
5, 6, 7, 8. Thank you. gonna go out with the right, out with the left. Brush in with the right, brush in with the left. So pa 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 pa, pa 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 pa.
Wanna give another try?
Autumn, you better do them. Em, you better do them. Everybody else, you better do them. So don't think you're getting out of these. But just no rolled ankles, please, because I need your feet and you to be in class when we get back.
Okay, you ready?
So out, out, in, in. Also, if you are nervous about it, you can use like the back of the chair or a counter or the end of the bed. I practice that way if you're feeling nervous about giving these a go. Just no rolled ankles, please. Ready? Make sure that you get some hang time, because if you're too grounded into the floor, you're not going to be able to get your sounds in, and you're not going to be able to also get off the floor. So make sure you get some hang time. Really use your plié, and try to see how long you can stay in the air to do your four sounds, and then before you land in five sounds. So we go left side. Let's do toe stands. I told you we were gonna do toe stands. Same thing for toe stands, like wings. You don't wanna be grounded into the floor or else you're not gonna be able to get your sounds in. So toe stands, toe, toe, step, step, toe, toe, step, step. But you should be in the air when you do your toe, toe, and then coming back down on the step, step. And make sure both, while you're in the air, both toes get their sounds in. So don't go toe and then try to come down and then on the other foot, because it just won't work and it'll be 10 times harder. So toe, toe, step, step. Toe, toe, step, step. So we're gonna do the right and the left. Ready, we'll do eight on the right, eight on the left, and see how we did, and then maybe we'll try one more time. Ready, here we go. Five, six, toe, stand. Grab water, you guys. I definitely need it. I'm sweating. Hear my breathing? Let us work on some pullbacks. We'll do regular pullbacks, syncopated pullbacks. Then we'll do single pullbacks. And then we'll practice our flat heels going forward. Auntie, that one's for you. I know you love it. So we'll throw that in there. Today is gonna just be a lot of technique and working on some tap skills, tap steps, like the basics, fundamentals, and then hopefully we're back in the studio soon. But if I will teach another class, let me know what you guys wanna work on, wanna practice. Maybe we'll just do a combo, something fun. But if you want things to be done in class, make sure you let me know. So then I make sure to include them for you. Okay. Hopefully you can hear my sounds and the music isn't too loud. So let's do our pullbacks. Same thing, a big, something that we're working on all class is hang time, getting up there, use your legs, use your ankles. We're gonna do regular pullbacks first. So we lift up, brush down, up, brush down. Again, if you have like two chairs, or two countertops, even if they're close together, or anything that you can hold on to on either side of you, just like how we practice with the ballet bars in class to push up, to kind of use those to push up and then get your brush sounds in there and then coming down, a really good thing to practice at home, or if you want to hold on again to a bed, a countertop, two chairs, one chair, whatever's going to be easier for you guys, to push, use that to push against you, not your full body weight pressing down, but just enough so you can get off the floor and get those sounds in there, because then try to not put all your body weight, because then if you step away, you might not be able to do it because now you don't have anything to hold on to. So try to use it as a helpful hand, but don't put all your body weight down there. Okay. Thank you. Good, you guys. We're gonna do single pullbacks. So all the power is just gonna be in our right leg on the first side. Same thing, weight over the balls of your feet, get hang time, use your legs, use your ankles to brush. So make sure you're not just scraping and then landing. Scrape, you have to come up, use your ankles to brush, and then come back down. Right foot first. Ready? The flap heels for Undine. If everyone else who likes them, but if you guys were here in class right now, she'd probably be asking me to do them, so those are for you, girl. Hopefully you guys are doing a lot of dancing at home, a lot of practicing and trying new things, working on things. Like I said before, if you don't have a tap board, I would highly recommend getting one. I'll make sure that I get you guys the name of the tap board I have, and some options. They're really not expensive, maybe $10, $15 from Home Depot, so if you're able to go to Home Depot, don't go out of your way. Stay inside, stay home. But if you have the opportunity to get one, I would recommend it just so you can practice with tap shoes inside and not scratching up floors. And please don't do it on the concrete, I mean, you guys know, but, or outside in a driveway or in a garage. Don't know. Okay, before I let you guys go soon, I know I'm sad our time together is almost over, we're gonna learn shiggy bops. Huh? Miss Alexa, what? A good tap step. A favorite tap step of mine growing up, actually, is called the chigago. Chair, I don't know, whatever you can use to push against, but again, not your whole body weight. So when we do a shiki bop, I'll show you what it is first, and then we'll kind of break it down. Shiki bop. Don't be scared. I'm seeing you guys freak out. Don't freak out. It's okay. Well, we're in this together. So you're going to keep the weight over your right foot first. Then we can add all sorts of heels and toes and make them really crazy, but I want to make sure that, I don't know if we've done these in my class maybe a couple times, but we're going to definitely start practicing them more. So while you have the time at home, these would be awesome to practice. So maybe once we're back at the studio, I can see your shaky box and your syncopated pullbacks and your single pullbacks. We have all the time to practice, right? So one more time, ready? Now we're gonna try with no chairs, no assistance, just us. Ready? Here we go. Pushing up on the right foot first. And here we go. That's it. That's all the time we have together today. I hope you're staying safe. and healthy at home. I miss you guys so much. I can't wait to be back at the studio and back in California, hugging you guys so soon. If you have things that you want, if you want another class, I mean, I got a lot of time on my hands. So if you want to do another class, I'm happy to do one for you. If there are certain things you want to work on or practice or learn, let me know so then I can do it in the next video or the next class, and then maybe we'll learn like a little dance or a little combo. But bye, you guys. Thanks for dancing with me in my home studio. See you soon.